Hi, and welcome to Back to Basics. In this episode, we will discuss design patterns for securing public URLs using Amazon CloudFront, AWS WAF, and AWS Shield. Do you find yourself doing almost everything online lately? Things like banking, shopping, or even doctor visits? Well, you're not alone. In recent years, majority of businesses have had to adapt and take their business online. But have you ever thought about how secure these online services are? For example, when you walk into a bank, you see a guard protecting the bank premises. But what's protecting your online bank? That's exactly what we'll discuss today. Let's look at an example and dive into how Amazon CloudFront, AWS WAF, and AWS Shield work together to provide comprehensive security. Say you own a boutique flower store called Any Flower Company, and you want to take your business online at anyflowercompany.com and deliver flowers in your local area. Assume your website's static content like HTML, images, and scripts are hosted in Amazon S3 and delivered via Amazon CloudFront. The application logic for handling and fulfilling orders is hosted in AWS Lambda. You also have your loyal user base who regularly place orders and they log into your website using their credentials. With this setup, a bad actor can launch an attack to hack into anyflowercompany.com's user accounts by repeatedly trying different credential combinations. This is known as account takeover and could compromise your customer's credential or personal information. By introducing AWS WAF to the architecture in conjunction with Amazon CloudFront, allows you to detect the malicious login activity and block the unwanted traffic, protecting your user base. AWS WAF operates based on rules that you configure, which determine what traffic patterns should be detected and filtered and what traffic should be allowed. AWS provides rules for common security threats like SQL injection, XSS, and account takeovers. You can also build your own rules specific to your individual website's traffic patterns. Now, let's say your website is under DDoS attack, where a bad actor uses bots, usually hundreds or thousands of them, to flood your website with traffic. This overwhelms your website and either causes bad user experience for your loyal users, or worse, causes your website to crash. Adding AWS Shield allows you to detect and mitigate both layer 3 and layer 7 DDoS attacks. AWS Shield comes in two variations: Standard and Advanced. AWS Shield Advanced provides advanced and comprehensive security against layer 7 DDoS like detection and auto-mitigation, and proactive support engagement from Shield response team who engage with your security team proactively to mitigate DDoS attack. The great thing about this architecture is the bad or malicious traffic is being blocked at Amazon CloudFront layer, which means your actual website resources in Amazon S3 and AWS Lambda are protected from security threats and from being overwhelmed. This architecture allows your online flower shop to protect its customer data, which in turn results in customer loyalty. This architecture also prevents loss of revenue due to potential disruption. Another advantage of this architecture is you can use Amazon CloudFront with AWS WAF and AWS Shield to protect resources not hosted in AWS as well. This accelerates securing public resources using AWS security services, regardless of whether they're hosted in AWS. For large organizations and enterprises that have a complex IT footprint spanning several AWS accounts, AWS Firewall Manager helps centrally manage AWS WAF and AWS Shield rules across all your AWS accounts. In this episode, we explored how you leverage Amazon CloudFront, AWS WAF, and AWS Shield to secure your public website and resources. AWS security services can be leveraged to not only secure your public resources hosted in AWS, but even those hosted elsewhere. Check out the link in the description below for more details. Thank you for watching Back to Basics. See you next time.